Hi everyone, so we were discussing about ResNet architecture. So yes, we understood actually if we are gonna increase the layer, so that there is not certainty that we will increase the training accuracy in the case of 34 layer plane that we have all like seen that the performance is not efficient as of the 19 layers VG19. So we basically introduced this residual network for following the like in the layers so that let's see how you are going to increase our training accuracy and minimize the training loss, and as well as how we are going to solve solve the problem of vanishing gradient descent and exploding gradient descent, which was which is a big issue with the larger number of layers. So let's see one by one. So this is basically a normal architecture of residual network. This is supposedly we can take these two layers. In between two layers, we are doing a skip connection. This is basically your what to say a residual network. So let's see what is the math behind it and how this actually works in order to give us advantage for higher number of layers. Let's see. And this is L plus one layer and this is L plus two layer. In that particular layer, actually, for initially, it is giving X, like X is the input to this particular L plus one layer. So here, actually, we have taken the skip connection. So we are skipping two layers and giving output to this next layer, like next to second layer. So let's see what is the math behind it. So AL is nothing but the output from the Lth layer. So this is the Lth layer. So X is nothing but the output of the Lth layer. So yes, if AL is coming as an input to this particular L plus one layer, so what would be Z? What would be Z for Z is nothing but which is going to the input to the ReLU activation function, right? Because in that particular layers we have used ReLU. So what would be the Z? Z is nothing but the weight of this particular layer. Weight would be like multiply with this output as we know the normal traditional neural network. So this particular the weight of this L plus one layer with the output coming from the previous layer with addition of some bias of this L plus one layer. So this particular input is going to the ReLU activation function which is there in the L plus one layer. So what would be the output for L plus one layer? So whatever the output that we are getting after the ReLU activation function, so this is nothing but the output of L plus one layer. So yes, we got L plus one layer output. Then this L plus one layer output would be going to L plus two layer. So what is L plus two layer? So L plus like what is the Z for L plus two layer? So whatever input coming from L plus one layer, that is our Z for L plus two layer. So Z is nothing but that particular input. L plus one is the input coming to the L plus two layer. So this particular input with the output and bias of this L plus two layer. So this is nothing but the input going to the L plus two layer. So actually we are doing the summation before transmitting this particular input to the ReLU activation function. So where actually we are doing one of the summation, fx is nothing but this particular ZL2, the like input for ReLU activation function is nothing but the fx. So and x is nothing but the output of the Lth layer because we are just keeping all the input in connection and passing this x value to do the summation before passing it to the ReLU function. So yes, what is the output before sending it to the ReLU activation function? So this is nothing but the ZL2, the input coming from L plus one layer plus we are doing the summation, that is L plus one. So this is fx, this is your x. Okay, so this is the normal math as you can see, so it is quite easy. So let's see what is the advantages. So what is the advantages here? So faster to skip connection. As we are skipping a lot of layers in between, so the back propagation and the feed forward propagation actually it faster than the normal. If you go through entire layers, it will take little bit more time. So during the back propagation removes vanishing. So as we are using skip connection, actually it able to remove the problem of vanishing gradient and exploding gradient problem, and also it regularizes. So it is also a regularization parameter that helps in overfitting. So in the training, actually we see in normal traditional neural network, if you when I use number of layers, actually we may suffer the problem, like suffer a problem like overfitting. So we can just regularize that parameter as well, just simplifying this fx is zero. So fx is nothing but this part, right? So whatever input going for this summation, that particular summation only we are sending this to ReLU, right? So here actually whatever the input coming from this L1 layer, that we directly sending to ReLU activation function, then that output we are sending to the L plus 2 layer. But here actually before sending to ReLU in L plus 2 layer, actually we are doing the summation. Summation is nothing but fx plus x. So if we convert this fx to zero, so nothing but we are just skipping the connection, because this particular two layers actually giving our fx value. Suppose you are not considering these two layers and directly propagating this x output to this particular layer, so it would be like it would be considering this fx as zero. So it helps us in overcoming overfitting. So you may ask question like how it is doing actually. So you know fx is nothing but this z2, so this is zl2, so this is nothing but the fx that I have told you. So fx is nothing but the input coming to the l plus 2 layer. So if that l plus 2 layer weight would be zero, so this weight l plus 2 layer weight would be zero and bias would be zero, so we can consider it, okay, so we can consider it fx would be zero. So yes, in this way we can overcome overfitting, and it is also easy to optimize for optimizers. As you are using several skip connection, actually it is easy for optimizer to optimize rather than using large number of layers without doing skip connection. Yes, it is easy to optimize. And one more thing, as you can see, it is using dotted skip connection. Dotted here also, actually it is used dotted here also, it has used dotted here also, it has used dotted. So dotted is nothing but actually here, as you can see, it the starting of the connection is for 64 metric size, right? This is 64 metric size and this is 182 metric size. So what actually it is doing during the summation, like as you have noticed in the skip connection in the residual network, we are doing summation. So if you are doing summation, this dimension so should be same, because if you consider matrix addition, the dimension should be same to do any addition. So here actually we need to increase the dimension before sending to the summation. So how it is gonna increase the dimension? So how it is gonna increase the dimension? Let's see. So how it is actually increasing the dimension? Because here actually in order to do the addition of this is if this network to the previous network. Because if you are addition this particular layer to this previous layer, so this fx dimension of matrix and this dimension of matrix should be same. So in order to increase, like whichever dimension is low, in order to increase that particular dimension, supposedly it has lower direction as per the diagram that I have shown you. So if this is a lower dimension, to increase, actually we are giving one parameters to multiplicate. Suppose we want to increase this particular dimension, we can multiply one non-identity matrix. Because if you do identity matrix, if you take identity matrix here and just do the multiplication, this would be same as this AL. So if you want to increase, so you need to use your non-identity matrix, because if you no need to increase the dimension, we just put here is put here an identity matrix, so that you can the summation of the network, residual network, will easily happen. So yes, this is all about residual network, guys. So thank you, thanks for listening.